is missing out.
On what?
On
your amazing personality.
It is a good thing you're going to be an engineering major, because you aren't very creative.
What am I going to major in? Getting dumped?
Oh, shut up.
What? I'm serious.
You're like what? 8th in the class?
5th in the class.
See? That's 100 places higher than I'll ever be. Don't roll your eyes at me.
You have a scholarship to USC.
Yeah, for running.
Oh, whatever. A scholarship's a scholarship.
Ugh. I just hate thinking about all the things I missed out on.
Like what?
I don't know, like friends, parties, even other relationships. It's all because of him.
I've dated him since freshman year. That's a lot of things to miss out on.
Then let's do something about it.
Well, are there any parties tonight?
No, like now.
What would we do?
Well, your parents have an alcohol cabinet, right?
Yeah.
And you drive, right?
Yeah.
Then let's make our own party.
Well, getting drunk in a bedroom is sort of depressing, so we need to go somewhere.
The view!
This happened way faster than I thought it would.
You didn't even have a lot.
Okay, I had enough.
It's what happens when you never drink.
Guys, before today, I couldn't even imagine my life without Mark, and now I hate him.
Oh, screw Mark.
Yeah,
screw Mark. Oh my
gosh. Alrighty. One.
Two.
Three.
Oh my god.
I got it. Really? You too?
We can spend the next 4 years at college together.
4 years till the rest of our lives.
Oh my, guys, we should egg his house.
House!
Yes.
We don't even have eggs.
But then let's go get some eggs.
I'm so down.
Yeah. Wait. Maybe, like, are you too drunk to drive? Like, maybe we should get an Uber or something.
I don't think I'm drunk at all right now, and I don't want my parents to find out.
Yeah. I honestly don't think you could get drunk, like, the first time. I'm like...
Yeah. No, yeah. I think I heard that somewhere.
Yeah. Okay, let's go.
Respond to Iola High School, Peyton and Bulldogs, for an injury traffic collision. RP states two vehicles involved and someone is seriously injured.
I'm in my bed. You're not here.
This one's not breathing.
I'm gonna have you come talk to the officers over here, okay? We'll check you out.
Is she okay?
What am I now? What am I now? What if I'm someone I don't want around? I'm falling again, I'm falling again, I'm falling. What if I'm down? What if I'm bound? What if I'm someone you won't talk about? I'm falling again, I'm falling again, I'm
fingers in my hand. Close your fingers and just leave one finger open like that. Okay? Here's what I want you to do. Just like you were standing, close your feet, put them back together. Here's what I want you to do. With your head back and your eyes closed, when I tell you to, you're going to take the tip of the finger that I tell you, whether it's left or right.
You can't say your name, you're almost at the hospital. Okay?
I'm the director of the emergency department, and you're Rachel's parents?
Dominic.
Dominic, then
Stella.
Stella, nice to meet you. Please, have a seat. Vital signs are stable, but we did a CAT scan, and there were some injuries from the accident, and unfortunately, she is paralyzed.
Oh, no.
From the waist down.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's not good.
No.
I mean, that's a permanent or kind of a temporary?
It will be permanent.
She'll be in a wheelchair the rest of the life.
Yeah, she'll be in a wheelchair. And if you're ready, we can go see her.
Yeah, today or tomorrow we have to face it. So.
I can't feel my legs.
take step. Take step. You'll be all right.
No, I'm paralyzed. No. I'm paralyzed. I can't feel my leg. I can't feel anything.
You can always come back.
I can't run.
Hi, my name is Teresa, and I'm the director of the emergency department. What's your name?
Veronica.
Veronica, hi, I'm Teresa. Hi. Alyssa is your daughter. She was brought in today. This is Deborah. You can go with her. She was brought in today. You know that she was in a car accident. She did sustain a lot of injuries. We have been working on her performing CPR. But I'm sorry that she died.
Hi, who is it? Hi.
Hi.
Can I help you?
I'm here to speak to the parents of Leo Perez.
I'm her dad. My name's Alvin Perez. Is she okay? Hi.
Can I talk to you inside?
Yeah, sure. Come on in.
Thank you.
All right, Officer Chow, I'm a little bit worried. What happened?
Mr. Perez, I'm here to tell you that we believe your daughter, Leah, she was involved in a car crash, and we believe that she's deceased.
I don't understand. Do you know, is it Leah, my daughter? How do you know who was?
We went to the vehicle and we saw her identification card, and we matched the identification card with her, and we believe that's the same person.
I don't understand. I just doctored a little while ago. Who is she with? What happened?
She's with her boyfriend, Paul, who we also identified, and they were involved in a car crash on Peyton Drive and Eucalyptus Avenue.
So you said she's not, she's dead?
Yes. I'm sorry.
I don't even know how to take this. Can I see my daughter? Where is she at now? You said Peyton. Can we go see her?
We can, but right now it's an open investigation. We believe the driver who crashed into her car was driving under the influence of alcohol. While at the intersection, that driver, we believe, ran red light and T-boned your daughter and her boyfriend's vehicle.
This is just crazy. I can't even understand this. Her brother didn't even know. Okay, I'd like to see my daughter if you could take me to go see her.
Okay. Is there any family member that you want us to contact?
We're from Texas. We just moved here, so I can't even think straight. Her mom needs to know.
Okay.
It's hard to think. I can't even think. She just turned 18 last week, and we got balloons still all over the house.
Okay.
So, I don't even know how to comprehend what's just happening. If we could just go see my daughter, my baby girl, I'd like that.
It's a lot to take in, but I will go ahead and take you over there. And just remember, it is an active investigation, so I can only take you to the location, but you can't do anything else.
Okay. No, I understand. Let's just go.
Okay.
Thank you, Spalding.
Okay, Karina, come on out of the car. Be careful of the step right here. Stand right here. Walk towards this open door. Walk inside, have a seat on the middle bench.
Remain seated, come to order. Court is now in session.
All right, good afternoon, everyone. First of all, is there any victim impact testimony or statements on behalf of the people this afternoon?
No, Your Honor.
All right. And Mr. Pierce, would your client like to make a statement of any type?
Yes, she would, Your Honor.
All right. Ms. Hirono, why don't you go ahead, and what would you like to tell the court, or who would you like to address?
I'd like to address all the lives that have impacted. I'm so sorry for all the things, for what happened, one destructive decision. I killed my best friends. I killed someone's life. I'm gonna have to live with that every day.
All right, thank you. Anything other than that on behalf of the defense, Mr. Pierce, would you like to be heard on sentencing?
Just briefly, Your
okay,
Honor.
Sure.
I would ask that the court grant leniency and grant probation on this matter. Ms. Hironas does not have any prior convictions. This is a tragic accident that while she is responsible for it, she is very sorry, as the court has heard. She has a bright future ahead of her. She's an honor student. She was looking to go to college and make an impact, a positive impact in the world, and I think that she can still do that.
Mr. Petter, what did you like to say about sentencing?
Your Honor, we believe that prison time is warranted in this particular case. Under California Rules of Court 4.421, there are rules in aggravation, specifically subsection 4.421A1, discusses a factor in aggravation where there's great bodily injury involved in multiple victims and the callousness of the conduct. Based on the defendant's decisions, there are two people that are now snuffed out. There's one person, Rachel Charles, that is paralyzed. There was another person named Paul Maradna that was injured. These are people that now are no longer capable of being able to enjoy the same quality of life that they previously enjoyed. Alyssa Quinones and Leah Perez have no life anymore. Their families have to bear the burden of their loss. Rachel Charles, by being paralyzed, cannot enjoy the activities that she would have otherwise had the opportunity to enjoy as a result of the defendant's decisions. And Mr. Paul Maradna was also injured as a result of the defendant's conduct. Because of the catastrophic injury involved in this case, the fact that there are multiple victims, we believe that prison time is appropriate, and we would be asking for the max of 18 years.
All right, thank you. I'm going to find that the aggravating and mitigating factors balance each other out, and I'm going to sentence you to state prison, but I'm going to sentence you to the middle term of 6 years. That's on count one. For the second count, gross vehicular manslaughter, reduce that to 1/3 of the term consecutive, so that's an additional 2 years consecutive.
So I guess I gotta stay now.
And at this time, I'm going to
some